Hi, I'm Erica Gamet with InDesign Secrets, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to do a text highlighter effect. I want to be able to select certain text inside my paragraph and give it a highlighter marker effect, much like the word apples in this sample. To do that, I'm going to create a character style. First, I'm going to go ahead and stylize the text, and then we'll create a style based off of that. So I'm going to select the word apples, and then what I want to do is add an underline effect to it. And if I just click on the underline button, I get just the basic underline, but I want a few more options. So I'm going to undo that, and then I'm going to hold down the option or the alt key and click on that underline button. And then I get all the different options available to me. I want to make sure my preview button's on so I can see what's happening. And then I want to go ahead and select underline on. And it gives me again that basic underline. But here's where I can make a few changes to it. First thing I want to do is I want to make a really thick underline because that's actually going to be our highlight. In this case, I'll go ahead and give it, let's say 65 points, and I'm going to hit tab. Now, of course, it's blocking the text, but that's okay because I know when I block out enough of it, I've added the effect that I'm looking for. So how do I move that? That's what the offset value is for. So I could just use my up and down arrow keys and move those around, but that might take a while. So I'm going to go ahead and put minus 20. Let's try that. I'm happy with that. That blocks out all the text. But right now I've given it a black outline on top of black text. What we want to do is make sure that the color is our highlighter color. And in that case, it's yellow. So I'm going to choose my yellow. And now I know it's a little hard to see because it's highlighted in the opposite color, but hopefully you can see the difference there. But I think that looks good. Let's go ahead and say okay to that. Now we need to save that as a character style so I can easily apply that to all sorts of text. With some text selected, I'm going to go over to the character style panel, and if it's not open, it's under Window, Styles, Character Styles. And then I'm going to Option or Alt click on the Create New Style button, and I'll call this Highlighter. Then I'm going to go down to the underline options and just make sure that everything's still set as I want, or I can make changes here. The only other thing that I would do is go into the basic character format and delete items that we don't really need. I don't need the font size and the font itself defined within this character style. In fact, I prefer my character styles to be pretty simplistic, and I only want the information that's important to me defined in the style. So we'll keep it simple, and the only thing we're going to define are those underline options. That looks good. We'll go ahead and say okay, and then apply that style. Now I can go throughout my text, select it, and click highlighter. We can even create multiple styles that have different colors. The easiest way to do that is to select some text that already has the highlighter style applied to it, then Option or Alt click on that new style again, and we'll call this pink highlighter. And I'll go to the underline options and choose a different color for the underline. And we'll say okay. And assign that style pink highlighter. Now we have text highlighted in different colors. And just for fun, I'm going to show you one more thing we can do. And I'm going to select one of these styles. And I'm going to go up to the character style panel menu and choose duplicate style. Let's go down to the underline options. And in this case, I'm going to choose black. And then I'm going to call my style redacted. So now I can select some text, choose redacted, and I can start redacting all the information that I don't want anybody to see. And that's the easy way to create a highlighter style within InDesign. Well, I hope you found that tip helpful. For thousands more InDesign articles and tutorials, be sure to visit InDesignSecrets.com. Thanks for learning with us.